through. I'm hoping to see some lightning on the planet. Come on. See, this is the perfect opportunity to see lightning. But with the GoPro, it doesn't show up well. Oh well, I still get to see it. Yeah, they're coming through. Yeah. See, yeah. It's real nice looking. Yeah. Just watch the repeat of the weather. You know, I keep telling people, storms no longer move from west to east. You know, here in Chicago, the rule of thumb is if it snowed in Denver, it's gonna snow in Chicago. That used to be the rule of thumb. They don't. It comes down from the north. You know? And they don't show the isobars anymore either. They'd be real close in certain areas. Just certain areas are gonna see high winds. Probably to the west of Chicago. Probably near the Mississippi border. You guys are probably seeing 40. Maybe 50 mile an hour wind. Oh yeah, look at it shifting and everything. See the big planet? See the big planet? Wow. Yeah, look at that. Isn't that nice? Ooh, down on the bottom too, near the horizon. They gonna swoop around. Ooh, did you see that gravity wave? See, you guys don't see it. I just saw a gravity wave. Yeah, I hope that got on camera. Yeah, I hope I got it. See, look, it's the dragon right in front of you. Yeah, brr. It's gonna be a dragon. See, puff, puff, puff. You see the little puffs? Right above the telephone pole. It's going downwards. Yeah, I see it. You don't. Yeah, love it. See, hopefully get a little bit more on the horizon. See, look, yeah. Try to keep your eye along the tree line. There's a bottom's gonna be wow. Yep, see how they're swooping around? They're gonna be, told you it's close. See how close they are? I can see us shifting and everything, so you know there's gonna be tidal waves or, you know, receding waters. Oh, look at that, there's a face right in front of you. Look, see, told you, right above the telephone pole. Right, looks like a horse, kind of. But it's the dragon, see? You see, I know this is biblical. You see, I've been trying to tell you, I know this is biblical. Because I was told by the sky images, the 12 dragons. And the 12 dragons means when this thing is at its closest in their orbit and the rotation, you see 12 dragons. The tribulations have started. I'm telling you. The seals are broken. You understand? I keep trying to tell you. The seals are broken. Judgment will come down. It's not fear or anything. Ooh, I just saw a flash of light up. See? And then, of course, they're not within our moon, though. You understand? They're not within our moon. They're beyond our moon. But they're big. You can see the outline of them. You see how that works? And you see 12 dragons. That means God's tribulations have started. The dragons of Revelations is not a star image. It is a sky image. How else could people in both hemispheres see God's, you know, signs? Just like an eclipse. Need to be able to see God's message from both hemispheres. That's why it's a sky image. I'm trying to tell you, understand? No. Oh, look, Earth is shifting downwards. You see, I can see. You see, if you're a keen, acute astronomer and observer, you can see the shifting of Earth because these planets aren't moving erratically. We are. These, okay? We're moving erratically according to what the sky's movements are. Look at that. A great phenomenon. See, these guys been wasting their time and everything, you know, showing you 10-minute, captures of weather cams and FAA cams, you know. You're still not getting the complete truth unless you come out here and boom. You know what I'm saying? Now I'm hoping we're going to see something cross the moon in about, 3 minutes, maybe four. I don't know if I got enough time on my card though. So we just going to look and wait, because something's going to pass the moon very shortly and light up. I filmed it once. It's going to happen again. Actually, I'm looking over there right now, but that's the planet, see? And that's how it works. And that's how we roll. And that's how we work. So now we're going to check out the moon. As you can see, the moon is completely enveloped in the debris field. Now, I had a question out there a long time ago. I was like, at the end of this event, how much mass do you think the moon will gain without having an atmosphere going through this? It has to be getting bigger. There has to be a new layer of dust laid down. Look, okay, here it comes. Here it comes, I bet you. I have this thing timed on. Watch. It's gonna light up. It's gonna light up. Come on, light up. I had these calculations confirmed by a college student up at the U, up in Badgerland. He's always pretty good to me. He said, "Yeah, you'll be seeing it." And I'll be like, "For real?" And he like, "Yup, you'll see it." One more second. Was that it? Was that a little private? I hope I caught that. I hope I caught that. I don't know if I did. You left a little streak. Can you see the streak? See? Told you. It left a streak. Told you. Told you. It left a streak. Yeah, that was awesome looking. Can we see it light up when it grows dark? Stitch your light up a bit. Come on, light up for me, girl. I didn't see it. Sorry. Oh, no. Yeah, go dark, go dark. I don't know if I captured it, but you saw the streak. That was awesome. Now we're gonna go back over here real quick and we're gonna see how the puff, the magic dragon, is coming. See the red one? Boom, that's going right there, right above the first set of wires. And look at the gas. You see, that's the atmosphere being blown off that planet. You see? And where is it going? Into that planet. You see? Look. You see? Boom, that's awesome, Dawson. Awesome, Dawson. And you see the one smaller planet the big one has right there. Man, that's awesome. But in between all that is like millions of miles of space. I don't know. Million. They orbit pretty close to each other. Oh, did you see that flash? Yeah, look at it, see? Here it comes. Oh no. Ooh, that's not gonna be pretty when it flashes again. Booyah! But that's how it rolls. You see how that looks? Looking kind of, you know, looking kind of like they were not. Ooh, another flash up there. I hope it gets it. But that's how it rolls up in there. So you see how they're orbiting. This one's coming around. See? And they're going to be, and then they're going to dip out again. See? They're going to dip out and bring a bunch of cold weather. You're gonna bring a bunch of cold weather. But yeah, that's how it rolls. They're gonna be, you know, the moon's probably gonna get covered in a few. Debris field is gonna be so thick. Watch. That's awesome. Man, this is a great capture right here. Look. Trails of them. Just trails of them. We're going to keep an eye on the moon. We're going to talk about, you know, how this debris field, just like the Book of Rev says, you know, the dragons that you just saw, its tail will wipe a third of the stars away. Well, me knowing the stars, you know, it's true. There's many sets of stars I can no longer see. You know, I can no longer see the Andromeda Galaxy. I can no longer see Pleiades. I can't see nothing. You know, Aquila, you know, Belleges. There's just so many I just can't find because, you know, it's, you know, a third of the stars have been taken away. And, man. Telling you know what I'm saying? So, you know, it just reaffirms, you know, everything I have witnessed, you know, up to this point, you know, and that's the shocking part of it, you know, is that I have witnessed every one of, you know, every one of God's prophecies, you know, the ground shaking. I saw the waters to and fro at Lake Michigan. You know, for 4 days they had a small craft advisory on the lake. You know, that's unheard of. 6 feet waves, you know, really swashing around. You know, I saw for myself. See how the moon left a little trail through the debris field. That was cool looking. I hope it captured that. You know, I've seen that, you know, trumpets in the sky, you know, and all this has scientific fact based in it. You know, all of it. And that is what confirms that it's, you know, God's work, because science and math is God's two truths. They never lie. You can never lose an argument using science and math. Never. Never. Prove it to me. What? I mean, how else? How else do you want me to prove it to you? You know, just do the research and observations yourself. Record the data. Have a few beers. You know, bless Mother Mary. You know, try to do right no matter what you've done wrong. Try to wake people up instead of keeping people asleep. Try to understand that you're fighting against, you know, the inevitable. So why you gotta lie about it? it's coming to its end. See, told you the moon would go dark. See how that works? Maybe not real dark. You know, I don't know. It's pretty thick up there. Yeah, you know that, how that works. And that's just, you know, that's the way they, because they're going around in their orbit. They're going across. They're going across again. And again, I am the only one who knows when they're going to cross. You know, and I'll capture it again. All the planets will be lined up with us. You know? Look at how the moon leaves a trail through it. See? All that debris going to the moon. Yeah. Look at that. That's sweet. All right. We're going to go back over here and watch how, you know, the sky in the east now. Now, that's actually the night sky in the east. See, but over there, because they're dipping around, and they're going to come around. It's going to come right over the night sky. Look at that. See, you can hear the funny, strange sound again. Maybe not on this, but you can. Oh, come on, Gillis. Come on, Gillis. Flat, flat, flick, flick, come on. But that's how it works. See, they're going in their orbit. And then when they're going to slide back to their parent star, you know, it's going to get cold. It's going to be, you know, clear in some places and very wet and snowy in others. Yep. But again, being here in Chicago, God has blessed me with, you know, clear skies because of the patterns of the weather.